Hello guys, me Carlos Sanchez, aka Happy Carnival 9, and welcome to another edition of F1 2019 Career Mode. So, this is part 2 of Best of Season 4 Highlights. So, it first starts me off with Monaco, which I'm not spectacularly that great at this track because the track very narrow, like a narrow tunnel vision, to tell you the truth, and not a lot of passing opportunities, so I call it my mulligan, to tell you the truth, and there's not much to learn from it, other than just ride around and hope you don't get into the back of anybody. See, right here, I'm just waiting and waiting until the traffic doesn't get clogged up, you know? And all I can say is have fun watching the rest of the video because I'll be winning races after the Monaco race, you know. So I'll fast forward a few clips and then for a few minutes and see what you guys think of the rest of this video series. See you later.
It's a well-deserved victory for Williams then. It looks like it's time once again to hand out the silverware as the successful drivers make their way to the podium. It was a gritty performance today by Williams. Let's see what effect this result has had on the driver's standings. Charles Leclerc's points today take him to the top of the championship standings. Some amazing talent out on the track today, but Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Nico Hülkenberg did an excellent job out on the track today. He played aggressively and knew exactly when to capitalise on openings throughout the race.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship.
So we're back, and the track we're on is Canada Grand Prix, Circuit Gilles Villeneuve. I don't usually record my qualifying laps because starting position don't matter. Just make sure you get to the front and beat your teammate, which is, for me, is Lewis Hamilton, easily, because he usually doesn't like running in the back. So I said that'd be an easy way to cap the season. So first lap here, mind my own business. Well, minding my own business. Yeah, just be a very quick short 5 laps, and hopefully when I edit this YouTube video, the laptop doesn't overheat, because my dad basically said, if you're gonna edit YouTube videos all day, make sure it's not 24 hours, like, all day, you know, or two. So, I have to listen to his word. So, I don't get other parents that are YouTubers and they actually want their child to produce and make money, you know, out of it. I'd say, hey, you gotta go start somewhere. Just make a few videos and hope some of them go viral. So I say Canada, this clip that I'm showing you, it was one of my best races. No flashbacks, no rewinds or nothing. Just a very smooth race. And it helps me manage my energy reduction system. You know, like you charge the battery, you deplete the battery, and such forth. I'd say resting could have been my occupation by now, but I'll stick to esports. So basically, that's my alternative if really a real life NASCAR or F1 contract don't come into play. And hey, I can make money off of doing this, which you can't really do, but, well, I might be wrong, because I haven't hanging out with enough people to tell them, oh, if I meet you face to face and we're going to talk about doing go-karts for the weekend, then bring it on. So put that aside. We're on lap 3 right now, 5 laps. And I'm stretching it out on Charles Leclerc and Valtteri Bottas. Like, in reality, I don't watch F1 on TV that much, because I don't have cable, just basic cable at least, because I save money from trying to finish college and then get a car and then get a job. And I mean, try to get a job that people will really care about, you know. And you have to do your research in order to get the best bosses, the supervisors, and so forth. Like, they're not going to be given to you, you know. You have to get accepted and then produce the best work, you know. That's all I can say about my life, you know. Let's see, we're two laps to go and trying to figure out what I should say, but not much really to do with the last two laps. Just, I'm not running around, I'm just stretching it out. And on this cloudy day in Montreal, yeah, overran that corner. But it's okay, I'm in the lead anyway. I just went outside today, so my pollen allergies are kicking in. Well, usually pollen don't stay here until May, so I guess pollen allergy goes away like sometime in May. So here's the final lap of the Canadian Grand Prix. So as I stretch out the lead from Charles Leclerc and, well, Valtteri Bottas passed him for a second. And as I stretch it out, my fuel mix and ERS deployment are really good for now. And ooh, I get into the wall, but that's okay, I'm in the lead. Ooh, what am I thinking? Ooh, now I just have damage on my right front wing. And look at the track, man. Look at that track, man, in the bottom left corner. Just stretching it out. And I'm going to win the Canadian Grand Prix easily. And let's check the point standings. Wait for it. Let's see here now. I probably believe that. Who was your driver of the day, Ant? Max Verstappen seemed to just effortlessly weave through the other drivers today without a care in the world. He was definitely my driver of choice. It's time to check out the constructor standings. The lead at the top comes down after a strong weekend. The point standings look like this. Charles Leclerc with an 11-point gap over me, so. So basically, it's part two of Best of Season 4 highlights. So if you guys want to move on and watch the rest of this video, you can. But otherwise, it's 40 to 50 minutes. So I'm AKA Happy Carlisle 9, and y'all have a great day. Have a great summer, and peace out. Thanks.
Between this weekend and last weekend. It's safe to say you're smashing everyone's expectations, isn't it? Do you think you were lucky not to end your race with that crash? Appreciate your time.
Mercedes are on top form once again after an excellent race weekend. It's great to see them up on that podium once again. So let's review the updated driver standings. Our championship leader is still sat at the top of the standings, but their rivals have made up some solid ground today. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Well, it's absolutely got to be Alexander Albon, no hesitation. He put in a performance today that's only going to build further upon his already growing reputation.
Let's move on to the constructors. Mercedes moved to the top of the table. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time? Be sure to...
and I can see the drivers starting to approach the podium for the victory celebrations. A real team victory today. Everybody played. So, let's review the driver's standings. Saliba takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship.
So we're coming to the end of my YouTube video clip right now. So if you're new to the YouTube community for my channel, Happy Carlin 9, you can click on the bell button to subscribe to my new content each week. Like my video with the thumb button, or the thumbs up button, or you can just drop a comment below the description below. So I'm Happy Carlin 9, and you all have a great day. Goodbye. Peace out.